You're listening to GIGI Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph. Happy Monday, girls! It's Steph here.
It's a new week, and it's Esther here, and I'm feeling excited because this Friday, girls, I want you to take note, we are sharing a recipe. We're in the kitchen.
I'm making a delicious recipe.
Maybe not too healthy.
Look, it's not the healthiest, but you can, you know, make it healthier.
Like a special
treat.
Yeah, so we hope you enjoy it. So, Steph, what's happening this week?
Okay, so we have a new challenge that we need to have a look at. But before we do, we have our new artist of the week, and it is Brandon Heath. Don't know if anybody's heard of him before.
I'm not sure. I think you've played him before, but I can't remember.
I have played him, so I don't remember how I came across. I think someone played it somewhere, and I was like, ooh, and then I went searching. So, yes, we're going to be playing him this week. And, we have our challenge. Esther, let's get our paper.
Okay. All right. Let's give it a shake.
Okay.
All right. There you go. Ooh, what's happening today?
Oh, okay. This is an interesting one. It says, make sure this week that you are in bed by 9:30. That means you're tucked in and ready to go.
I think even if you go to bed to just read and de-stress, that's a good thing to do.
Yeah.
That's a good thing.
You know, sometimes, you're up late, you're doing your assignments or finishing off things. But it is important to have sleep. Mm. There are actually benefits to sleeping on time by night before 9:30 because your body actually does a lot of things during the night at different hours. Their body needs to cleanse and detoxify itself, kind of thing. Like reset.
Yeah, I like that. I mean, I like to go to bed early because we wake up really early.
Yeah, so I'm a bit of a hand. Sometimes by 8 o'clock, I'm like dozing already, 8:30. Yeah, I'm like, 8:30.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so the other thing we have is we have GIGI Notes. Don't forget to sign up. We're going to send the recipe.
Oh, yes. You don't want to miss out on that. It's delicious.
Yes. So make sure it's completely free. There's a link below that you just click and send it, and we'll put your name on our list. And then we have a new verse of the week, which is a beautiful one.
Yes, it's one of my favorites. So this is going to be a bit of a revision week for me because I already know it. It is Exodus 14:14. It says, the Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still.
I like that. So God is saying, you know, whatever you're going through, stop fighting. I'll handle it.
Yep. Don't get stressed. Don't get frazzled. Don't get worried. I've got it. Let me fight for you.
I like that. Today's devotional is called The Blind Man and the Paralytic. Author unknown. There was a small village in the middle of the trees, at the foot of a mountain. There lived a man paralyzed from his feet, who barely moved and dragged himself on the ground. In front of his hut lived a blind and stubborn man. The two of them had fallen out for some unknown reason. The truth is that every day they found an excuse to argue heatedly. On more than one occasion, they wished each other's death. One day there was a fire in the forest, and the fire began to devour the huts of the village. People fled the place, but no one helped the blind man or the paralyzed man. These men screamed for help. The blind man was walking around in his yard trying to escape, but he could not discern the path to take. The paralytic, on the other hand, saw that there was still a space in the middle of the forest to flee, but he knew that he would not be able to crawl so fast to save himself. It didn't take them long to realize that the only way to save themselves was by joining forces with each other. In the midst of despair, the paralyzed man offered to help the blind man to guide him on the way, in exchange for him to carry him on his back and take him with him. The blind man gladly accepted, and thus they managed to save themselves from death. After all this, the men realized that their enmity was useless and harmful. They apologized and became fast friends. Romans 12:16 says, live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited.
Oh, I love that story. It's kind of cute. I could just imagine two little, you know, cranky old men not wanting to get along, but then needing each other.
And they had to humble themselves to, to ask each other for help.
I love it. But we will come back and comment on that a bit more after this song by Brandon Heath, The Light in Me.
Thank you.
Of feeling where we don't like someone, or we somehow there's a rift that's happened, it's gotten bigger and you forget why.
Yeah.
But as Christians, we actually should try to be at peace with everyone. And I think like the verse you read in Romans, you know, we have to live in harmony with one another and not be proud. I think we can be pretty proud people.
Yes. And I think the first place that we have to start is with our family.
Yeah,
that's where it begins. So sometimes we have this frenemy situation relationship between siblings or parents, especially mums and girls, mums and daughters, sometimes dads and sons.
Yeah.
And then sometimes we could just fight with people all around us, wherever. And, you know, this causes a lot of division, a lot of anger, a lot of hurt, and it really gets rid of the peace. have in our heart.
And I think it's like a waste of life to be living so bitterly when, you know, you could be living harmoniously the way God intended it to be, you know?
Yeah, I agree. And I think, you know, we are all children of God. And sometimes we forget that.
Yeah.
We are children of God. And as and his kids, we have to remember that he taught us that we have to love all of our enemies.
He does say that, yes.
Which is hard. But it makes a big difference when you just give it to God.
Yeah, and he also says, love others as you love yourself.
Yes, he does. Yeah. So, yeah. You know, this reminds me of I was quite young. You were born.
Okay.
But I remember in that neighborhood where we lived, across the street there was a lady and she hated my family. Like, she hated us.
Oh.
Because we were Christians and she didn't agree with the whole, you know, Christianity thing. And so she hated us so much. And I remember that my parents, I mean, she would stand out the door and she would say insults to them.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And just really nasty things. And my parents were always so gracious and so patient. I mean, I was a little girl. I was still in my own world, but I remember that. And my parents never said a bad word to her. They prayed for her when we had family worship. And they would just keep her and her family in prayer. And I remember that one day, this lady had to humiliate herself and come to our house. Because her son got really, really sick, as in death, on deathbed. And she knew that we were Christian. And for some reason, she thought, you know, deep down, she must have believed in God. And so she came and talked to my parents to pray for him to come and visit and pray.
Oh,
so Maria and I think it was mom and dad, they went with her and they prayed for the son. And God healed him.
And so was she changed after that?
Yes, she changed, I don't know, for a few months maybe. But then when her son was well and everything, she started the whole thing.
After everything that, she's like, oh, wow.
Yep, she forgot. And then her son got sick again, really, really sick. And he had none of his, I think his organs were stopping, like they were becoming paralyzed. And he was so ill. His stomach grew so much. Oh. He lost his hair. It was like a type of cancer or something. And he was like 15.
Oh.
He was young. He wasn't old.
That's horrible.
And the lady didn't go back. She didn't come back to ask my parents to pray. And her son passed away.
Wow. And that's so sad.
It was so sad.
But I didn't get her mentality, like, she hated you, then she asked for your help, then he got better, then she hated you again.
Yeah,
and she forgot all about it. And then he got sick and then, okay, I don't know.
Yeah, and the son was pretty much like her as well. It was sad. But yeah, so, you know, showing mercy and love to the enemies is a really big thing.
It is, and it's hard to remember to be gracious when you want to defend yourself. That's hard. But
like the verse says, be still.
Yes.
You know, God will fight for you. So why, if people tell you off, why
bother?
Stand there and tell
them? And almost like sink down, lower yourself down to their level.
Yeah, no, it's not worth it. And then you feel bad for it anyways.
Actually, you do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so that's all from us. Until tomorrow.
Oh, yes.
And we hope that you are enjoying these. Let us know what you think and email us or send us a voice memo or whatever.
All right, girls, let's get ready for prayer.
Dear Lord, thank you for today because we're beginning a new week. And I just ask that you help us stay strong. And when people tell us off or when people fight with us, may verse Exodus 14:14 really be clear. And may you stand and fight for us and we can just be still. Thank you, Lord. And thank you for always protecting us under your wings. In your name I ask. Amen.
This has been GIGI Radio signing out.